Welcome back, my Reichbusting friends, and welcome to episode 2 of my series of quick painting videos for Reichbusters Project Vril. Let's get on to episode 2, and in this one we're going to be painting a whole stack of Nazi zombies and Nazi soldiers. Now, I don't know about you, but I like to get the grunt figures out of the way pretty quickly. There's 28 figures here, and I want to do them fast, so I can spend more time and attention on the hero figures. So grab yourself a cup of coffee, put on an audiobook, and let's get through these figures fast. So here's the Nazi figure. Now, I'm sure there are people out there who know a lot more about World War II uniforms than I do and say, that's not the right colour for a Nazi soldier in 1944, whatever. This is weird war. I don't really care. I want something that's close to what they wore, and I don't care if it's exactly right for the period. You, of course, may want to research this further and do something exactly accurate, but I just stole this colour scheme from an example photo online of this miniature that I thought looked good. Now, I've since found out, actually, that the gun here didn't have this wooden stock. This was a completely metal gun. So that's not accurate at all. I've just painted in a strip there to look like a wooden stock. But I don't care because it looks quite good and it adds a bit of colour to the figure and makes it look a bit more interesting. So it depends on you whether you are worried about these things or not. The first thing I do, of course, is the flesh areas, and it's just the face for this one. I use Kislev flesh. Here it is. And just very roughly paint in that face area. Then it's time to do the cloak and pants. And this is a German sort of grey, greeny colour. And to get this, I couldn't find an exact colour, so I did a mix of Cabellite green and Mechanicus standard grey. If you look here on my Redgrass Games wet palette, you can see this is the Cabellite green. It's quite bright. This is the Mechanicus standard grey. If I mix them together, I get this nice grey, greeny colour. And that's the one I'm using for my Nazis. After you've done the cloak and pants, just mix a little bit of black with your greeny grey colour and paint in this area of shadowed cloak and be a bit darker than the pants. After painting in that greeny grey colour, I want to do all the black areas. That's his boots down here. And the gun pouch and his belt, and he's wearing gloves, and there's some black straps here as well. More black straps on the back, more belt pouches, things like that. That is all done very quickly and easily with contrast black Templar. And this is a contrast paint, so it flows on straight from the bottle onto those areas. Just be careful it doesn't flow too much. But you can easily keep it within all those black areas and paint them very quickly. The helmet is done with Mechanicus standard grey, probably mixed with a little bit of black to make it a bit darker. And I've painted the grenade handle with Doom Bull Brown. This ammo can, or whatever it is, I painted with Castellan Green. The strap of his goggles here is painted Dryad Bark. And of course the gun itself is painted Ironbreaker. The next thing I did is go through with some Runefang steel and pick out all the little details of metal. So there's the little iron cross at his neck, there are the buttons, there's an insignia on his arm here. You can highlight the gun a little bit while you're doing this. Some little spots here, all these little spots of Runefang steel just make all these little details pop out a little bit. So very quickly and easily, you've painted all the major areas. Now it's time to give the figure a wash. So when I'm doing the washes, the first thing I do is wash the face. And when you're washing flesh, your friend is Seraphim Sepia. Give that a little bit of wash and depth. And really, that's all you need to do. You can highlight the face a little bit if you want to with a bit of Kislev flesh mixed with white. I didn't even bother with these because it's such a tiny area. So when you do the wash, I used Nuln oil, and for that I washed all the metal areas, and I just used it to pick out some of the shadows and some of the darker areas. I didn't wash the entire figure with it, but just the helmet around there, there's a bit of a scarf around, or whatever that thing is called, around his neck. That was the same colour as the helmet. That's picked out as well. Just picking out all this area and the straps and everything with the wash. Once you've let that dry, of course, a little bit of highlighting will make it look even better. And I haven't done anything too fancy here, really just on the grey-green areas I mixed a little bit of Corax White with my grey-green colour and just did some highlights. And they're just along the edges of the
fabric, just the little places where the light would hit. It's not too drastic a highlight. Your wash is going to pick out some of the detail. There's a little bit along the raised folds here, a bit here. Then I do the same with the grey areas, the boots and the weapon pouches and things like that. Mix a little bit of white with my grey colour and just pick out those so the black gets a little bit highlighted. A little bit on the helmet as well. You can do as much or as little of this as you want. A few quick strokes gives it a little bit of depth and makes it look a bit better. Finally, for the bases, for these concrete-y tile-looking bases, I use the same technique that I used for the card trays, which is black to start with, then a very rough dry brush of Sturmvermin fur mixed with black, and then lightening that up to a lighter dry brush. And then finally, when that's dry, I gave it a wash of Agrax Earthshade, and that gives it that dirty kind of feel and breaks up the grey a little bit, makes it look a bit more interesting. And then, of course, black painted around the edges of the base. And there you have it, Nazi soldiers. Well, there's quite a few of these to do, and they're a little bit boring, but you can see it's pretty quick and easy. They're mainly that grey-green colour, and then just picking out the detail. As I said, the contrast black will pick out all these black areas pretty easily for you. You could go into more detail about painting all these little bits in here, but really, you don't need to. These are grunts, and they're going to die pretty quickly on the board, so don't spend ages painting them. Instead, spend your valuable time on things like hero figures. All right, much the same philosophy holds for the zombie figures. Here he is, poor looking guy loaded up with that thing on his back, not looking very healthy at all. You can see the uniform he's wearing is the same grey-green colour that I used on the Nazis. You can see I've highlighted it just with a bit of white. I don't usually highlight too much with white because you can get a bit of a chalky finish, but because this grey-green colour is so grey, there's really not much else you can highlight with. Just don't overdo it. The boots, as you can see, exactly the same. The face is painted with a bit of rotting flesh. I'm not sure if that's an old Citadel colour or not, if they've still got it, but it's basically just a light, greeny, fleshy colour. The eye patch is painted with a little bit of Runefang silver, a bit of metal. And then there are two red dabs for these strange eyes with tiny little white highlight dabs. He's got some metal piping coming out of his mouth. And then the other main thing really is just this armor. And for this, I didn't want to use a metallic armor. I went for something closer to World War II German tanks, which is a sort of bluey gray color. And that color is shadow gray. And I think I mixed a little bit of Mechanicus standard gray in there as well to make it a bit more gray colored rather than blue. And that's washed with Nuln oil and then highlighted up with white added to the base color. And I didn't even go to the trouble of doing that by hand. I just dry brushed on that highlight because these are zombies and there's heaps and heaps of them, easy to do. The only thing I did to make this look a little bit more interesting was to give it another wash after it was dry with Agrax Earthshade. And that just made it look a bit brown and oily. And then I got a bit of the weathering powder that I used on the card trays and just rubbed it into some of the little corners to make that look a little bit grotty and used. Finally, with a little bit of watered down white, I painted on this symbol. Very easy to do freehand. And there you have it. Zombies, very quick and easy to do, and you want them to be because you've got quite a few to do with them. There you have it, folks. Quick and easy, no mucking around, and before you know it, you'll have all these 28 figures done and you can move on to more interesting figures. Just mix yourself a good batch of that grey-green colour and use it for all these uniforms. And then just pick out detail with that contrast black. And of course is the flesh colors. And give it a wash. And then a little bit of a highlight. And Fritz is your uncle. While I'm here, I'll walk you through a couple of other very quick and easy figures to do. These are the dogs, the guard dogs. And you can imagine how easy this is. You just paint it with that contrast black again. And then give it a bit of a dry brush with black mixed with a bit of white or whatever grey you want to. Save your lightest highlights for things like the tips of the ears. Paint in the nose black. Paint in the eyes. In this case I used a dark brown colour with a little bit of red in it. That was Doom Bull Brown. Some very tiny dots of white just to bring those out. Then I painted the collar with Zerius Purple. Oh, these names, they're so hard to say. And highlighted that with Slaanesh Grey. then a little bit of rune fang steel to paint that little tiny cross there. And he's done. Quick and easy. Now for the base, this is more of a brick texture. So I used Mournfang Brown, roughly dry brushed over a black undercoat, and then highlighted that up with mixing a little bit of Kislev Flesh to the brown, and again giving it an Agrax Earthshade wash afterwards. Done! Next up are these things, and as you can see, these are super, super easy. These were primed black, a heavy dry brush of Iron Breaker, a very light dry brush of Runefang Steel, and they're pretty much done. And you can do the base while you're there as well, because it's the same metal texture. And then for the eye, just a tiny little slit of red in there with a little highlight of yellow. Very, very easy. Give it all a wash of null oil, of course, and maybe a little bit of Agrax Earthshade to make it look a little oily as well. And these guys are done. The only last thing I did, and you can skip this step if you want to, is paint these little wires or cords or whatever they are black, and then I did little grey highlights just to highlight them up. Not even worth doing, really. You could almost dry brush those and get away with it.
There we go, my fellow painters. You've ploughed through a whole heap of zombies and Nazi soldiers. They are done. I always find it really good to get those grunt figures out of the way so I can have more fun concentrating on the other ones. It's a little bit tedious working through so many figures that are the same, but if you do them in batches, you will find that you'll speed up your painting. So do them in maybe four at a time, do all the same colour. In fact, if you really want to plough through them, just do all the same colour all the way through, and then go back and do all the same colour all the way through. All the grey-green, then all the black, then blah, 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 blah. And that's a really quick batch way of getting through your figures and getting them done. And remember, they're grunts, so don't worry about it too much. You can spend all your attention and love on the more detailed hero figures. Of course, there are a lot more enemy figures to get through before we get to those heroes, and I'll be continuing in the next episode. Hope you're enjoying this. Hope you find it useful. Esoteric Order of Gamers, orderofgamers.com. I'm on all the usual social media channels. Please subscribe, hit the all notifications button, and don't forget to check out all the other things that the Esoteric Order of Gamers do. I'll see you in episode 3.